Lisa Delgado.
And I'm Trey Womble.
And this is Wolves TV.
Ulyssa, do you feel that?
Feel what?
It's the holiday seasons, everybody. That means Thanksgiving is right around the corner, and Christmas, in a blink of an eye, will be upon us. Now, that means that in a few short weeks, it'll be the end of the quarter. Let's see.
Thanksgiving, food, friends, and family. As you may know, Thanksgiving is always celebrated on the fourth Thursday of November, where we also get a full week off of school, right?
Wrong.
Unfortunately, this year round, we only get 3 days off of vacation instead of all the five. And next week, we'll have school on Monday and Tuesday, and we'll go to all seven periods on those 2 days. But after that, we'll have the rest of the days off to ourselves. Don't worry though, because if you're mad about not getting a full week off, I got some good news for you. Winter break is still on the same schedule, so we'll get our regular 2 weeks off. But since we won't be in school for 2 weeks, the last day to turn in any missing work will be on December 17th on a Friday. And if things go well, we should start school again on January 3rd, 2022. So try not messing up the date. But other than that, go enjoy the holidays with your friends and family, and remember to have fun.
Wow, time really does fly. Okay, attention to our video production students. If you want to come to Reno, Nevada with us, then you have to attend our very first Skills USA General Assembly. Here's some more information.
Attention all video production students. As you may know, we are already part of the Skills USA program, and right now their activities are about to start. Now, if you want to join or are already a part of, but you have to pay a $30 entry fee, which is on our school website, which is currently being shown on screen.
You have to be a member in order to join in on competitions and activities. Our first general assembly will be on Monday at 2:30 in Miss Arevalo's room. It is imperative that you join this first meeting, as it will be discussing very important topics such as our state conference, the trip to Reno, leadership roles, and a lot more.
If you have any other questions about what Skills USA is or the meetings,
go to Ms. Revel's room and talk to her.
Now you know, VP students. Skills USA meeting next Monday, 2:30 at Ms. Revel's room. Now, it's time to talk about our own state champions. As you may know, our men's soccer team has recently made history by winning the Nevada 3A state title along with the regional title. What does that mean for the rest of us? Check it out.
Four states, 10 schools, all major sports, and dozens of athletes. But only one team holds a state championship among all the SLAM schools nationwide. Our boys soccer varsity team. The whole team had an amazing season, and with the guidance and leadership of our four senior captains, they were able to pull off this amazing milestone.
Both competitions are hard, and we ended up facing the same team in the finals for both, and we beat them twice, fortunately, and I think it really helped that the core of our team has been together since seventh grade, since the school basically opened, and I think that's something to help separate us from the rest of the competition and ultimately give us that state title.
Well, based on our state championship this year, I feel like more talent will be produced, more kids are going to try out, so they'll be fine. They'll do very well.
During the 6 years of existence of the soccer program, our players have had several coaches that have dedicated their time and knowledge to help them grow and succeed.
Each coach that I had through the years helped me get to the place I am right now by demanding the highest standard of me and making me have to constantly work hard and improve.
I'll cherish it for the rest of my life because not many kids get a chance to win state. And especially being that I'm a SLAM student, I was the very first person ever at SLAM to win a state championship. It means a lot, and I'll remember it for the rest of my life.
Our boys' soccer team demonstrated out on the field the SLAM High Five: accountability, perseverance, respect, integrity, and most importantly, leadership. Go Bulls!
We are so proud of you guys. And before we go, we want to leave you with some messages from our school community. As Trey said, Thanksgiving is right around the corner, and we have a lot of things to be grateful for. Check this out.
Hello, Bulls. What is the SLAM family thankful for? Well, we had some reporters go around and ask, what are you thankful for?
My name's Coach Rollins. I'm a head wrestling coach here, and I am grateful for the weight room.
My family, especially my grandchildren.
Thanksgiving, I'm thankful for my family, my friends, and my job.
I'm thankful for family, friends, health, and of course this job.
I'm grateful for my mom, my dad, my house, my clothes, my room, and my school.
My name is Beth, and I thank my family, my teachers, and my learning abilities.
I'm grateful for my family and being able to attend to the school, and that's pretty much it.
Okay, so my name is Alexander Corral, and I'm grateful for my family, friends, school, and sport.
My name is Haley Johnson, and I'm grateful for my dad, my family, my dogs, and my house.
Take this time to enjoy with your friends and family. Hope you all have a great Thanksgiving.
All right, Bulls, that's all we have for today. Just a reminder, you will not be seeing me or Ulysses next week because it will be Thanksgiving break.
And we want to wish you all a happy Thanksgiving and want you to remember to
be smart, play fair, and stay safe.
See you guys next time.